Well, Jeff, if you could introduce yourself, your organisation, how long you've worked with your design organisation, and where you actually come from.
My name's Jeff Hussain. I'm the regional coordinator for Somewhere Two for the Northwest. I've been working in this position for 6 months now, but prior to that, I worked for the Blackpool Window Young People Services as a participation worker, and I do that currently at the moment as a volunteer.
So, Jeff, in terms of your work in Blackpool, what challenges do you think that the communities want to face in the future?
I think there's two major issues. One of them is a cohesive society, a cohesive community, and the second one is funding. I think in terms of cohesive community, Blackpool's always had the problem of different communities mixing together. But I think now that there's less and less funding, and the funding is being squeezed up quite a lot, that's having a massive impact on the way communities mix together. And although there could be an argument made that there's plenty of resources, plenty of brand new facilities being built around Blackpool, it's important to remember that sometimes facilities can only do so much, and it's more about the people themselves. And if the people don't want to mix, then it doesn't really matter what kind of facilities or what kind of education is being provided.
So, in an ideal world, what kind of things is your organisation, is it somewhere at all capable of producing in an ideal world?
To be honest, I think the opportunities are endless. We've got very talented young people who produce all kinds of material, whether that be educational or whether that just be for their own entertainment. You know, we have street dancers who are always looking to not only showcase their skills and talents, but to be able to teach other young people how to do that. We've got actors, we've got dancers, we've got artists, and all these talented young people need an avenue to be able to show what they're good at. So really, for me, in terms of the creative element of it, and that's really what we focus on in terms of Somewhere Two, the opportunity really of what we can do is quite endless. However, I think, again, one of the biggest issues, again, is around funding and making sure that there's enough funding to continue that process onwards, because the last thing we want is to have funding for this year, which is the Olympic year, you know, the big year, and then come 2013, everything just disappears.
So in terms of those problems, what one of the biggest problems that you or the people, you know, people of your age in your generation, what kind of problems are they facing?
I think unemployment is the biggest one within Blackpool. Blackpool's a very small town with not a lot of opportunities, you know, and there's a lot of people unemployed out there after the financial crisis and all that kind of stuff. And I think the job market has got a lot of young people in there, you know, a lot of fantastic graduates who have got amazing degrees, but there aren't any jobs. And you know, then to travel outside of town, you face similar problems, whether it be a city or whether it be a town. For me, I always go back to that crucial point of funding, because living in Blackpool my entire life, and then to know that 48 million is being cut over the next 4 years from the local authority, and the first things to go are youth services, services to young people, and stuff around, you know, the college itself having to lose members of staff, and all these cuts which are affecting young people directly. I think that will have a massive impact on future generations.
So, related to the EduPunks method, as we explained, is the internet important in your work? How do you use the internet to facilitate?
To be honest, the internet's very, very important, as well as just using emails and as well as just using general kind of internet access. You know, I use social networking a lot to get to young people. And without that form of communication, I think it'd be very hard to relay messages. You know, young people, yes, they may have phones, but they check their phones less compared to the social networking now. I think that social networking is such an important element. But just accessing information, accessing opportunities, you know, the opportunities that I managed to get from my young people were only because primarily of the internet, you know, me searching what's out there, but also building links through mechanisms such as emails. And without all that, it'd be a lot harder to do the kind of work that we want to do. You know, sending people places, trying to book things, all that kind of stuff is now done through the internet. Without that, I don't think we'd be as successful as we are.
So, what would you want from an open resource that could be produced by EduPunks? What would you want? If we could produce anything, what would it be?
I think for me it's not necessarily what the outcome would be. I think for me it's who drives that. And there's a lot of communities out there and there's a lot of people out there. But for me the main drivers have to be the young people. And that's simply because they're the ones who will be using those tools. And if they develop them, they take ownership of them, they will be sure to pass them on to their friends, their families, and the future generations. And if we simply develop tools and materials based on what other members of society say, then we've got to remember how that filters down to young people, whether young people will actually take any interest in that because they feel they have more ownership.
One final question, what does punk mean to you?
Punk means to me those people with big hairs, big spiky hairs, a lot spikier than mine, and a lot of piercings and kind of heavy metal, heavy rock kind of music.
Yeah.
Maybe a stereotype, but that's what I see. When someone says punk, that's the best thing.